Come in close. Because the more you think you see, the easier it'll be to fool you.
Ladies and gentlemen,
for our final trick,
we are going to rob a bank.
On the count of three, you will be teleported through space and time to your bank in Paris.
One, two,
three. Everyone in this room was a victim of hard times.
Some of you lost your homes, your cars.
And so tonight,
we're going to return some of that money back to you.
Thank you, everyone.
Good night.
Can you explain to me how you went from Las Vegas to Paris in 3 seconds?
What do the kids call it these days? Oh, magic. First rule of magic, always be the smartest guy in the room.
Your bank was the distraction while they set up the real trick.
Expose them now and destroy them.
Hang on. I've got nothing.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for the delay.
Whatever this grand trick is, it was designed a long time ago. And I believe that what's about to follow is really going to amaze. Look closely. Because the closer you think you are, the less you'll actually see.
They have magical powers. I think for the first time I'm disappointed to see that in a movie. While I usually love special effects and I'm a big fangirl, I guess you could say, I was really hoping that this film would be kind of looking at the sleight of hand tricks that magicians do in real life, and they would use those to rob banks. But instead, this looks a little bit like a CGI fest, which I guess I should have expected with the director, Louis Leterrier, from the Marvel Hulk reboot and one of the Clash of the Titans movies. So I was kind of holding out hope at the beginning of the trailer, but when Jesse Eisenberg transferred his handcuffs to Mark Ruffalo, I started to lose a little bit of faith in the film. And to tell you the truth, this might have downgraded it from a see in theaters to a rental for me. But, you know, that's just my opinion. I do really like the casting. I'm still really excited about that. I love that they put Jesse Eisenberg in the lead role. It's such a refreshing change of pace from the usual generic Hollywood heartthrob lead they would have usually cast. But Jesse Eisenberg just screams somebody who's really interested in magic in real life. And I think that's fabulous. And again, it just underscores, though, that I wish that they had used actual magic tricks and, you know, the tricks of the trades for magicians in Vegas. I was hoping for Ocean's 11 in that vein, but it looks more like a superpower movie. But that's my thoughts on it. What do you think? Is the cast still enough to get you in? It is a dream cast with Woody Harrelson and Morgan Freeman and Michael Caine. That's fantastic. I would have liked to see some more Michael Caine. I don't know who has Michael Caine in their movies these days and sidelines him, unless that's a sign that he's not in the movie very much. But what do you think? Do you think Jesse Eisenberg can be a blockbuster star? And are you disappointed that it's not magic tricks? Or do you like this, that they have magic powers angle? Or maybe, do you think I'm wrong? Do you think that you can actually do those tricks with magic? Although transporting someone, I don't know. The transporting from Vegas to Paris, I don't know. We'll see. So write your thoughts down below. And as always, thank you for coming to Beyond the Trailer, not just for the latest trailers, but these quick snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching.